Should you finance or buy your cell phone? A look at the numbers. When it comes to cell phones, there are two types of purchasers, the buy it outrights and the payment planners. People who buy their phones outright believe that purchasing their phones upfront will put the power in their hands. They believe they'll save money in the long run. The payment planners, I've been in this group for years, look to get the cost of their phones rolled into their contract, avoiding the upfront cost. But the questions still stand, which is the better way? Should you buy your new phone outright? Should you avoid the upfront cost? Should you pay it all upfront? Should you put it off, and pay in little installments, over the next 2 years? Let's take a closer look. Cell phone financing, this works by adding the cost of your phone, divided by the number of months your contract is for, on top of the normal plan price. So if your phone costs $1,200 and you have a 2-year plan, it'll be an extra $50 per month. Sounds simple enough, but there are pitfalls you need to be aware of. Be sure when you sign on for a contract, you know the length of the term, i.e. 2 years, the amount added to your bill each month for the purchase of your phone, and when your phone will be paid off. The last point is the most important, since once you've finished paying off your phone, your monthly cost should go down. If it doesn't, you're paying extra for no reason. In days of yore, once upon a time, if you wanted the latest device, you had two options: buy it, or you could pay it off on your monthly phone bill with a large down payment in the range of about $150 to $200. Then came the 2-year contract and the $0 down payment. That was a big break for consumers. It meant we could have the freedom to move around and buy out the remaining balances on our phones, having them unlocked for free. Today, things are changing. Many telecom providers are moving toward a system like Qudos Tab. When you financed your phone with companies like Bell and Rogers, your bill would be a set price, somewhere around $70 or more, depending on your plan. The problem is that it would stay there, even after you finished paying for your phone. With the rise of companies like Eastlink, the bigger companies are shifting gears. Bell offers something called Smart Pay, which allows you to pay $0 down and split the cost of the phone over 24 months. Eastlink's entire system runs on this model. If you're purchasing a phone through them, you can buy it outright, or you can finance it over 24 months. When the phone is paid off, your bill drops the monthly payment. The pros and cons of buying and financing. So is buying the phone outright still worth it? Let's look at the pros and cons. The pros and cons are pretty straightforward at this point. If you don't have upwards of $1,000 hanging around, you can't afford the new iPhone or Samsung Galaxy. So the reason people buy into the 2-year plan is to make that large payment feel like it disappeared. People feel like they can afford an extra $30 or $40 a month. So, when Bell offers a $70 per month plan for 5 gigabytes of data, and unlimited calling in Canada, suddenly adding $40 for the latest iPhone doesn't seem too bad. In the end, it's just 0% financing. If you stay on top of your bill, you aren't paying any more for the phone. A tip for financing your phones: if you can't afford the full upfront cost, like most things you buy, be sure to shop around. Bell isn't the only company offering this type of deal. You can make payments with a variety of companies, like Eastlink, Rogers, Qudos, etc. Tip: Eastlink offers the same phone as Bell, on a 24-month installment plan, for $10 less per month, saving you $240. So, are bring your own phone plans cheaper? Taking Best Buy's price of $960 for an iPhone 11, some tabs may actually be cheaper, especially Eastlink's plan, which saves you $260 over the 2 years. The mental side of the game, but there's another important part of the phone purchasing game: consumer psychology. It feels better to pay an extra $40 per month than it does to pay $1,000 upfront. Then after we're done paying off the phone, we're usually ready to get a new one and keep on paying that tab. There's a reason Bell will sell you the phone through their Smart Pay system for $40 per month. It'll cost you $960 over the course of your 24-month contract. You'll save $20 overall and avoid the upfront costs. But you'll be on the hook for 24 months. If you're unhappy and want to switch carriers, you'll have to Cancel your contract, pay your outstanding balance on your phone, and pay any early cancellation penalties. And let's face it. If you didn't have the money to pay for the phone outright, you probably don't have the money to pay the remaining balance. You're stuck. Then at the end of it all, they get to send you another notification, you're eligible for a free upgrade. And the cycle starts again. The case for buying your phone outright, even though you may not save money on buying the phone up front, there are still reasons to do it. When you buy your phone outright, you feel differently about the purchase. You feel its weight. The surgical removal of $1,000 from your bank account may hurt a little, and may require some general anesthetic. Financing your phone through your monthly bill may feel great, and even save a little money. Here's a personal example. My current phone is almost paid off, with less than $100 left on it. And yet, I've already started thinking about my next phone. It's been less than 2 years. Many people, like me, are on the new phone ASAP train. We see the new phones launched each year. New displays, more cameras, better cameras. When did we get so obsessed with phone cameras? My point? I could pay off my phone and just keep it. I don't need a new one. But I'm used to getting a new one, I'm already planning on it to add that payment right back onto my bill. But why? If I just pay off my phone, then my bill will be $30 less every month. That's money in my pocket. That's why I think I'll buy my next phone outright. If I feel the sting, I'll be less likely to pull the trigger on a $1,000 purchase. I could invest that $30 per month in an RRSP, or use Wealthsimple to invest it with a low-fee fund. Buying your cell phone used can help. If you don't mind a slightly older phone and don't want to get hooked into the financing scheme, then buying a used phone can be a great way to save some money. You can usually get a 1 or 2 year old phone in great condition for about half the price. But be cautious, a few pointers. When purchasing anything from a private seller, avoid sending an e-transfer before you get the goods. When buying a phone, make sure you insist on seeing it before you buy, check its condition and functionality, confirm it's unlocked, and see if you can set up the phone on a plan. One of the best situations would be to have the person meet you at a telecom provider's brick and mortar location and have the phone set up there. The verdict. So, does buying your phone outright save you money? The answer is yes, kind of. It's better if you use the pain of purchasing the phone outright to keep you from buying new phones all the time. And it's better if you use the extra money saved each month from lower phone bills to invest. If you're a trendsetter on the cutting edge, I recommend saving up. The added monthly expense of a financed phone won't cost you more, but it could create bad spending habits. If you don't have the money up front, take comfort in the fact that you might save money overall on the phone, depending on which provider you choose. But be cautious that you don't just keep on financing. Let your bill drop once your phone is paid off, then invest the extra. Start letting your money work for you. Just remember that you're locked in for a 2-year payment plan on that phone. If you're a big saver, buy your phone used. This will get you a lower monthly payment right away and save some money on a decent phone by purchasing a used or out-of-date one. What about you? What side of the fence are you on? Do you know what you'll do the next time you need or want a new phone? Let us know in the comments below. And if you like this article, please consider sharing with your friends. Thanks for watching. If you liked the video, please hit the like button. If you want to see more videos, hit the subscribe button. And if you have something to say, please leave a comment. See you in the next video.